If we've learned anything from pop culture, it's that the zombie apocalypse will likely start with animals eating something weird. And, newsflash, animals always eat weird stuff. We should probably be keeping an eye on old Fido when he starts chowing down on something, natural. From a seriously uncharming worm to parasitic wasps. Join us as we count down 15 things that turn animals into zombies. Number 15. Horsehair worms. Don't be misled by the cute, quirky name. Horsehair worms are not anywhere near as magical or charming as they may sound. Actually, they're more like the chest burster from Alien than, well, anything cute. Be warned, you can't unsee this. The horsehair worm is not exactly a worm, it's more of a parasite, finding its way inside a host and taking over its brain to hitch a ride to the nearest water source. And if that's not the very definition of a zombie, I don't know what is. This footage shows a horsehair worm shortly after emerging from the now dead corpse of a nearby praying mantis. I don't have to explain that the host never survives an encounter with the horsehair worm. Once this thing bursts out of your body, it's really all over for ya.
See, it's actually trying to move the mantis, it looks like, or at least it's... or else it's just stuck in it. I'm not sure what's going on.
The horsehair worm, thankfully, doesn't affect humans, but it's still one of the most frightening insects in the world, if only for the fact that it can so easily turn animals into complete zombies. I mean, it's for a good cause, I guess. Everyone needs to stay hydrated, but not like this, guys. Before we go on, like this video, smash the subscribe button, and click the notification bell right now, or this centipede will crawl on your face when you're sleeping. Number 14. Parasitic wasps. In the movies, the zombie pandemic is always caused by a virus, but in the real world, such a condition would almost definitely be caused by some kind of parasite. For instance, these wasps from the family Ichneumonidae, which turn spiders into unwilling slaves, or if you prefer, zombies. While conventional logic may tell us that the wasp has more to fear of the web-making spider, science tells us quite a different story. Some wasps, such as the Hymenoepimus argyraphaga, a name I never want to say again, are notorious for their attacks on orb-weaving spiders. When stung by these wasps, the spiders become temporarily paralyzed, allowing the wasp to deposit an egg on the immobile spider's abdomen. The spider will then continue as usual, unaware of the egg, until it hatches, allowing the larvae to attach to and feed on the spider's blood. Eventually, the adult wasp will produce chemicals that can control and influence the spider's nervous system before eventually killing it. It is quite literally a zombie. For many, the idea of spiders in general is about as terrifying as you can get, but a zombie spider controlled by a wasp? We're in no sleep territory here, folks. Number 13. Zombie ant fungus. There is a reason that you're told not to go around eating whatever fungi you might find in the wild, and it has nothing to do with magic mushrooms. Okay, it has a little to do with magic mushrooms. Certain type of fungi can alter your brain, or if you're an unfortunate ant, transform you into a zombie, kill you, and then make you become the new fungus. Yikes. Ophiocordyceps fungi, also known as zombie ant fungi, are known for their ability to alter ants' behavior and mindset, and the other insects that have the misfortune of eating it. Any ant that becomes infected by the parasite is often shown to exhibit unusual behavior, including falling over random. But it gets worse. When the fungus takes over the ant's brain, it causes the ant to find a cool, damp place to bite down on the underside of a leaf. Once it bites onto the leaf, it's as good as dead. The fungus basically locks the ant's jaw muscles, allowing the infection to kill it, and let the fungus grow through the ant's head to reproduce and kill others in the same way. So that's fun. The zombie ant fungus can, in theory, wipe out entire colonies of ants, making it one of the deadliest threats to the insect community since shoes first came on the scene. Number 12. Emerald Cockroach Wasp. It's often said that cockroaches could survive anything, including a nuclear attack. But one thing that they can't survive? The Emerald Cockroach Wasp, a parasite that turns them into cockroaches before... Well, I think you know how the story goes. When the female wasp finds a perfect cockroach to target, all it needs is one perfect sting to temporarily paralyze the victim. With two stings, the wasp injects venom, containing neurotoxins, that will work to block aspects of the cockroach's brain.
The wasp's venom simply disables the roach's escape reflex.
Once the venom has taken hold, the wasp breaks off the cockroach's antennae and drinks its blood, finishing off what is basically a hostile takeover of the cockroach's body. At this point, the wasp can control the cockroach in any way it wants. So the wasp leads the cockroach to a prepared nest and lays its eggs on the cockroach's abdomen. That egg hatches, the larvae begins feasting on the cockroach itself, forms a cocoon inside the body, and eventually breaks free as an adult wasp, which is grim. So, no, cockroaches can't survive everything, but then when you think about it, I doubt there's an animal on the planet that could survive a parasite going into their body and using them as a host. Maybe Keith Richards, maybe. Number 11. Paralphestrongylus tenuis. Look, I'm a talented voiceover artist, but even for me, Paralphestrongylus tenuis is a challenge. So instead, we're just going to call this the brainworm. And yeah, it's pretty much exactly as horrific as it sounds. The brainworm is a parasitic nematode that generally tends to seek out white-tailed deer hosts. But they're not picky. These animals also have been known to hijack the bodies of moose, mule deer, reindeer, sheep, goats, alpacas, and llamas as hosts for their sinister intentions. When the brainworm gets into the body, it immediately penetrates through the spinal cord and eventually the host's brain. Before long, the brainworm will begin disrupting and affecting the nervous tissue through various tactics, causing the host to behave in unusual or abnormal ways before, well, dying. Even zombies have to die eventually. For some time, scientists have wondered why so many moose are dying without explanation. As it turns out, this brainworm is the main culprit, successfully killing the animals without drawing too much attention to itself. Give it a few months, and this parasite will be the focus of an HBO documentary. Number 10. Toxoplasma gondii. Toxoplasma gondii sounds like a pretty complicated organism, but it's fairly easy to explain. It's a single-celled parasite that overwhelms and manipulates the brains of its hosts, eventually changing so much that the victim ends up walking into its own death. Some people would call that love, but not like this. When rodents are infected with the parasitic Toxoplasma gondii, they soon begin acting most unusually. Rather than being terrified of cats, the very animal that would happily kill them in seconds, the rodents lose their fear entirely and instead become unusually attracted to the smell of these animals. As a result, the rats and mice begin seeking out the cats, which inevitably leads to them being eaten, but the parasite doesn't die with the rat. It gets passed on to the cat. Soon, Toxoplasma gondii begins reproducing in the intestines, causing the common disease toxoplasmosis, which can be spread to humans. It's long been speculated that the zombie apocalypse would begin when lab rats escaped and infected humans. Little did we know that we had zombie rats in front of us the whole time, and we just never knew about it. Actually, now that we know about it, I'm not sure I really wanted to know about it. Number 9. Cordyceps. Despite what you may be thinking, magic mushrooms are no longer just for curious college kids. Apparently, even nature is getting in on the psychedelic action. Albeit with a pretty sinister and zombified twist, Cordyceps is a genus of fungi, with most species being parasitic. And you know what that means. Cordyceps primarily attacks insects and other arthropods, though some have been known to attack other fungi, but it's what happens to the insects that is truly, truly horrifying.
From 2012 to 2017, caterpillar fungus prices rose an average 20% every year.
When a cordyceps attacks, its bacteria injects and invades itself into the body of its host, slowly taking over until it has completely replaced the host tissue. From there, it's all pretty horrible. Having taken control of the host, the cordyceps begins using its mind control powers to fully override the host's body. Before long, the cordyceps is ready and waiting to take over another host, and the cycle of zombification continues. From a biological standpoint, cordyceps is absolutely one of the most horrific parasites in the world. And while it does tend to focus exclusively on ants and other insects, that's little comfort. It's basically a horror movie, but just really, really small. Number 8. Rabies. Given that it's a well-known virus, you'd be forgiven for not knowing that rabies is actually a pretty severe parasite. And one of the most frightening to boot. Just one bite from these suckers, and you or your animal will become more aggressive and need to spread the virus. Basically a living nightmare. Rabies is actually one of the only parasites that pose a threat to both animals and humans alike. This parasite is spread from host to host via saliva, typically from a scratch or bite. When they get infected, the host becomes more aggressive and eventually manages to spread the virus through a bite or scratch, not unlike zombies. And hence, the zombie army continues to blossom and grow until it eventually grows so large that we're all truly doomed. So that's a fun fact for us. Despite the widespread claim, rabies does not, in fact, make you afraid of water. It does, however, make you a zombie, and zombies don't really like water anyway, right? Or was that vampires? Either way, you don't want to be bitten. Number 7. Euhaplorchis californiensis. Of all the parasites in the world, the Euhaplorchis californiensis is easily one of the hardest to pronounce. It's also one of the most fatal, and it goes on one heck of a journey in its life cycle. Some may say it's a life that begins and ends with poop. The Euhaplorchis californiensis is a parasitic worm that begins its life in the droppings of birds. When the eggs of these parasites hatch, the larvae then immediately latch onto a killifish. Once these larvae manage to reach the fish's brain, they cause the animal to start wiggling and squirming, attracting passing birds' attention. That obviously leads to the poor little larvae getting eaten up by the birds, but that's not the end of the journey. The parasites then continue to grow and reproduce inside the birds before being released back through the birds' droppings, and the cycle continues on. Thankfully, the Euhaplorchis californiensis is probably not a parasite we will have to contend with, unless you're someone who tends to eat bird droppings, but probably not. Still, the zombie process in this parasite is cynical. It will quite literally never end as long as people are willing to eat that. Let's talk about something less gross. Number 6. Sakulina. Here's a question to ask yourself. Could an animal with a shell become a zombie? Surely the protection afforded by the armor would prevent that from happening, right? Wrong. Sakulina is a sea barnacle that trades its own shell for a crab. And it does that by, you guessed it, zombieifying the crab. After locating a worthy target, the female sakulina invades the unsuspecting crab, growing a number of tendrils that will reach every single part of the crab's body before taking over entirely. After the female created a hole in the shell, the male sakulina enters and lays eggs inside. From there, the crab is completely and utterly helpless. Unable to mate and living entirely under the influence of the sakulina, the crab is forced to protect the eggs as if they were its own children. That's pretty bleak, but also kind of fascinating. Maybe it will surprise you to know that this is not exactly an uncommon occurrence. For many crabs, the sakulina is an unfortunate fact of life. They will eventually be taken over and destroyed by animals that wish to use their bodies for their children. It's a Disney movie just waiting to come to life. Number 5. Leucochloridium paradoxum. I know, these names just keep getting more and more crazy. But if Leucochloridium paradoxum is a little too complicated and, well, scientific, you can just refer to it as the worm. Just try and remember that it's not the Gul'dan's. Actually, the Leucochloridium paradoxum is a parasitic flatworm known to invade and take over its host, snails, slugs, and birds. In the case of those birds, the worm can't actually transform this huge animal into a zombie, but it doesn't really need to. The bird is merely a middleman, allowing the worm to lay eggs in their stomach, which will then be transmitted through their waste and into the snail's digestive system. At that point, the worms infiltrate and attack the snail's internal system, overriding their eyesight and making them more vulnerable to potential predators. What a way to go! The Leucochloridium paradoxum may sound like a complicated little thing, but it's really not. All it wants to do is invade a host, take over their body, get them killed, and reproduce. Honestly, if that's not modern love, I don't know what is. Number 4. Chronic wasting disease. Now, I will be the first to admit that chronic wasting disease sounds like something you should be concerned about. But actually, this particular infection only tends to affect deer. So you should still be worried about it, but you can cancel the 14 crates of protein powder you just ordered. The chronic wasting disease is also known as zombie deer disease.
Chronic wasting disease has been found in deer and elk in Colorado.
Because guess what it does? Oh yeah! For reasons currently unclear, some deer in the world suffer from this unique condition and its debilitating side effects, including brain lesions. Brain lesions that ultimately deteriorate and result in death. While more study is required to fully appreciate the causes and symptoms of this unique condition, it goes without saying that these increasingly devastating brain lesions have a tendency to make the deer behave in ways that are un-Bambi-like. I mean, they're not seeking revenge on hunters or anything, but still. The chronic wasting disease is probably the most significant threat to the deer community outside of professional hunters and drunken frat boys who insist they're still capable of driving. And yes, sadly it can and does turn deer into zombies. So I guess Bambi's mom might still be alive. Who's to say? Number 3. Canine distemper. Unless you're a massive fan of them, you probably don't know much about the biggest cause of death in the raccoon community. Spoiler alert, it's humans, but the second biggest cause of death to raccoons is distemper, a highly contagious disease. It ain't good, folks. Raccoons are actually susceptible to infections both by canine and feline distemper, both of which are truly awful viruses. But we're focusing on the canine variety, the side effects of which bear a startling resemblance to our old undead chums. When raccoons have been infected with canine distemper, they begin showing some relatively mild symptoms, compared to what comes later, conjunctivitis, pneumonia, diarrhea. But things truly kick into high gear during the final stage of the disease, as the raccoon grows disoriented and confused. The symptoms, which include paralysis and other bizarre behavior, are caused by brain damage and can often be incredibly hard to differentiate from the symptoms of rabies. Because this disease is cyclical, canine distemper can easily wipe out entire colonies of raccoons. And yes, we've all seen the movies and other media. We know that the zombie disease is pretty tough to stop without a big-ass gun. Or science. Actually, probably science. Number 2. Plagiarhynchus cylindraceus. These names are just getting out of control. But I practiced for several hours, so I'll stick with it. The Plagiarhynchus cylindraceus is a parasite that takes over all manner of otherwise cute insects, like the potato bug or the pill bug. And unfortunately, they're not taking over to help. Like many parasites, the Plagiarhynchus cylindraceus is typically found inside the intestinal tracts of birds. In this case, starlings. And when those starlings have fully digested the parasite inside them, they release the parasite's eggs in their poop, which is then quickly eaten by the pill bug. Once it gets inside the pill bug body, the parasite immediately gets to work, taking over the little guy's brain. With his new zombified bug host, the parasite sets out to do some truly crazy stuff, like making the pill bug's location clear to its natural predator, the starling. And just like that, the parasite escapes and heads off to find a new victim. So to sum it up, Plagiorhynchus cylindraceus is really just a fancy way to say psychopathic mind controller. This is an animal that lives to destroy the lives of unsuspecting pill bugs, which even insect haters will agree is a pretty cruel life purpose. Well, some of them will agree. Number 1. Lady Bird Parasite. The greatest lie that nature ever told was that ladybirds are somehow innocent and not at all dangerous. In actuality, these insects are more than capable of taking care of themselves. However, the ladybird has no chance of fighting against the parasitic ladybird wasp, one of their worst enemies. Here's how this works. The ladybird wasp needs to find some kind of host to protect its eggs from potential predators looking to do harm. The ladybird, meanwhile, has its distinctive spots to scare away potential predators.
And basically any other small insects that it comes across, it will try and eat.
Therefore, according to the laws of algebra, A plus B equals AB. Unfortunately, I failed algebra, so I can't solve that equation. But what I do know is that the ladybird wasp lays its eggs inside the ladybird shell with a single sting. And then, the trouble begins. Once the wasp's eggs hatch, the larvae immediately start chewing through the ladybird's body before bursting through its chest to spin a cocoon. This is about as close to Alien's chest burster scene that nature seems to get. But you know what? It's still pretty disturbing to think about. Those poor unsuspecting ladybugs who suddenly realize that, well, the word heartburn is soon going to take on a different meaning. Which of these weird zombie creators do you think is the most disturbing? Let us know in the comments. Also, check out our other cool stuff showing up on screen right now. See you next time.